The truthful history of successive Irish government's attitude to culture, arts, music, events, and the crew that stand behind them is a history of lip service without real and tangible support. And that, of course, is most obviously reflected in the fact that we spend 1/6 of the average that is spent across Europe in funding the arts and culture. And in the case of the events and music sector, they've essentially never received a penny, and there's not even been an engagement until they began to get themselves organised in the last few months through groups like EPIC. Now, I asked for the first debate after the pandemic in this house about the issue of arts and culture, and then requested that we would have groups like EPIC come before and the National Campaign for the Arts come before the COVID committee. And since then, the level of lip service to arts and culture in here has grown exponentially. There's no doubt about it. From virtual silence about arts, culture, music and events, there's a literal cacophony. It's almost a cultural event in itself. The level of lip service and rhetoric that has been expended in saying how much people love the arts and how and music and how much they contribute to our culture and society, which is absolutely undoubtedly the fact, and never have we needed them more than in the utterly grim situation that we now face. But lip service has still not been matched by tangible support. In fact, apart from a few paltry million that was added to the funded sector, still bringing it nowhere near the European average of expenditure in that, really nothing has been given. I mean, €1 million for music is just an insult, to be honest. It's an insult compared to the contribution that musicians make. But actually, when you take it in the round, the cuts that you've imposed to the PUP and the wage subsidy mean you give a little token and then you take it all back. Because you see, the PUP payment and the wage subsidy are the payments from government that actually reach everybody in those sectors. All the crew people, all the music people, all the artists, all the performers, all the people who've lost work. That was the one payment they all got. Frankly, it wasn't enough. And it wasn't tailored in such a way that they could do a bit of work on top of it if they were lucky enough to get a bit of work. But at least they all got it. And that's the one thing you have cut. And that is the one thing that all of the groups representing arts, music, culture, EPIC, the Events Alliance, the National Campaign for the Arts have said restore and retain the PUP and income subsidy payments, and indeed allow people to earn a bit above that. And that is the key question. And then beyond that, whether you're going to give grants to cover the costs or the ongoing costs of insurance, repayments, and all the other ongoing costs that they are still incurring, even though there is no work out there for them. Are you going to give that scaffolding folding for the reduced capacities in venues, or indeed no capacity in venues? Are you going to do it? That is the question. And so far it's been lip service rather than tangible commitments, and frankly the engagements look tokenistic, and some of the reports I'm hearing is that's precisely what they are, tokenistic. And of course all those connected to them, the indirect jobs, the 35,000 jobs and others beyond that, like the taxi drivers, they're all asking the same question: how are we going to be able to pay our bills? How are we going to be able to pay our rent? Will we be able to survive? I have one company in music written to me today who asked twice for the wage subsidy, and they give work to 300 different musicians and they were refused twice. I don't know how they don't qualify. It's unbelievable that they're not qualifying for these things. So let's stop the rhetoric and deliver the support. I just want to draw in my last 20 seconds one contrast. There is one exception to all of this, and that's the film producers. Right? No, virtually no ongoing employment.
in the industry, but you know how much they've got in the last number of years in grants, tax relief and all the rest of it? 668 million euro. It dwarfs what the rest of the arts and culture has got. Now, I believe in filming industry, but when there's no jobs, it's shocking. So let's support the artists, let's support the performers, let's support the crew, let's support the musicians.